Hey folks, GSAP 3.14's out, and there's a small but powerful update in there for MorphSVG. Let's have a little plugin recap and check it out. You can see MorphSVG in action here. Look how natural and fluid the motion feels. That's largely down to the morphing shape transitions. Morphing lets us create motion that's a little bit more interesting than the usual transforms by manipulating SVG path data. So under the hood, MorphSVG animates the data inside the D attribute. This string of numbers and letters describes the shape of the path. You can hand author it if you want, or you can just export SVGs out of a vector graphics editor. MorphSVG is really clever, but it's super easy to use. You just drop in your start and end paths, and MorphSVG will animate between them with perfect shape fidelity, even if the start and end paths have different numbers of points. This one line of code is all you need most of the time, but if you stumble on a morph that looks a little bit odd, there are plenty of config options to help you out. New in 3.14, you can set Smooth Auto to add extra anchor points to the artwork. You can think of it like increasing the resolution and giving MorphSVG more points to pull on. You can set a specific number too if you prefer, like Smooth 80. shapeIndex is also really handy. It controls which points in the start shape get matched up with which ones in the end shape, like an offset in the sequence. You can see here how it influences how the morph behaves. Another lesser known but super useful feature is the render function. SVG can be a little bit resource intensive sometimes, so if you're animating a large area of change and you need maximum performance, you can draw the morphs to canvas, just like Roman does in this amazing CoDrops article. I'll make sure to link to this article wherever I post this video, and the demos in this video are up in the shiny new GSAP demo hub. Check them out and have fun experimenting.